Now we're going to be a little informal. Guys, come on, I'm ready. I'm done talking. You probably thought I'd never finish. We've got to, I don't know if you've ever noticed this about us, but we notice it all the time, that it takes us a while when we get up here to get warmed up and get going. And the first few songs aren't as good as hopefully some of the others that come along. So we're going to start out now and sing a couple of songs that we don't plan for the album. These are songs that are off of our latest tape that is available back in the foyer. And we want to sing a couple here and get loose and get over our nerves. I don't know about you guys. I heard somebody say I'm about as nervous as a new mother.
Or a new father.
Jesus is the key. It is work for my ancestors, for my dad.
my children and work for their children too. No matter where you're headed for, what counts is where you've been. I've been to the cross of Calvary. That's where life begins. For every generation, for every tribe and tongue, there is peace for every nation if we stand together as one. United we will stand for the cross of Calvary. For every generation, Jesus is the key. From Parkersburg to Ashland to Michigan, our home, we will have the memories of people that will last the whole life long. With Jesus at our steering wheel, how can we lose our way? The center of our life is Jesus Christ. That's where he will stay. For every generation, for every tribe and tongue, there is peace for every nation if we stand together as one. United we will stand for the cross of Calvary. For every generation, Jesus is the key. Jesus is the key. Jesus is the key.
Mark, how'd we do on that? How far flat did we go? Right on?
Whoa.
Oh my goodness. If you see me doing this, it's not that I'm saying, hey guys, we're really doing a great job. We have a tendency to go flat. You probably never noticed that. None of you probably ever noticed that, but we have a tendency to go flat. And if we're sitting around my dining room table and we need to get it up a little bit, that's my signal. Okay, so now you know.
He's doing that for them, but he means me.
Hey, listen, before we start, too, I don't want anybody coming up here drinking my water. One of my girls handed this to me, and she said, I put your name on it. I said, there's 100 guys out there that's named Dave. Don't you touch it either.
She would have said, Granddad.
Is that everybody? You ready, Jeffrey?
All right.
I had a word of sound there.
That is in the video.
Yeah. We really do thank you all for coming. It's such a great encouragement for us. We just love you dearly, and we're just thankful to the Lord for you. God bless you. Give yourselves a hand.
Happy in the Lord anyway. And did just today, how God told him to lead his children out of the miry clay. And when old Moses' work was through, he had done the Lord's command. Then God took Moses to the mountaintop to look over in the promised land. I'm gonna move on up the mountain, get a little closer to the promised land. I wanna look down in Canaan while on the mountaintop I stand. I wanna see the milk and honey flowing. When I leave this world, that's where I'm going. I'm gonna move on up the mountain to look over in the promised land. Just like Moses, I will climb that mountain tall to see the place where I'll be going when I bid this world goodbye. And just like Moses, I'll press along and follow God's command, and then move on up the mountain to look over in the promised land. I'm gonna move on up the mountain, get a little closer to the promised land. I wanna look down into Canaan while on the mountaintop I stand. I wanna see the milk and honey flowing. When I leave this world, that's where I'm going. I'm gonna move on up the mountain to look over in the promised land. I'm gonna move on up the mountain, get a little closer to the promised land. I wanna look down into Canaan while on the mountaintop I stand. I wanna see the milk and honey flowing. When I leave this world,
thank you.
tell you this, and I told another group this, but I got to tell you this. A few weeks ago, we were over at Dwight's house, and we were practicing, and Dwight said, "Oh, by the way, there's something I got to tell you." He said, "This is not a bald spot." He said, "It's a solar collector." I said, "Degree, you guys ought to have enough heat to heat Detroit." When's the last time you read about it? Joshua. Joshua was a great individual, and he took over a tremendous job from Moses, led those children of Israel there across the Jordan into the Promised Land, and boy, they fought battles, and just lots of things happened, and day after day after day, God just proved himself over and over to those people. The only time they ever failed was when they chose to do things on their own and leave God out. That's when they fail. But it seems like even seeing all the glory of God and all the wonders that he performed, they kept turning away from him and turning to other false gods. And so one day, Joshua called them all together at a place called Shechem, and he said, "Listen, I've had enough of this. The Lord's had enough of this. You make up your mind right now who you're going to serve. Is it going to be the gods that your father served beyond the river? Or maybe the gods of the Amorites in whose land you're living?" And then he made a choice himself. And it's a choice that every one of us should make. We should use Joshua as an example for us and make the same choice that he did. He said, "As for me and my house," and he said this in front of all of these thousands and thousands of people, "As for me and my house, we're going to serve the Lord."
We stand here together as a family. We join hands together, lifting praises to the Father above for sending his Son.
We're all sinners and we're all in this together. But praise God, Paul writes to us in Ephesians 2:8, "For by grace you have been saved through faith, and that not of yourselves. It's the gift of God." Oh, listen to that. We have something that so many people out there in this world who are sinners just like we are don't have. We have salvation through the grace of God. He sent His Son to die for us. He sent His Son. We're saved by grace.
If you could see what I once was, if you could go with me back to where I started from, then I know you would see a miracle of love that took me in its sweet embrace and made me what I am today, a sinner saved by grace. How could I boast of anything I've ever seen or done? How could I dare to claim as mine the victories God has won? Where would I be had none that brought me gently to this place? I'm here of sin.
going home. I can hear the sound of angels as the saints go marching in, singing praises to the captain of the blood-washed bay.
Well, praise God, I'm a member of the blood-washed band. I've been washed in the soul-cleansing blood of the Lamb. I was bound by chains of sin till one day the Master came and made me a member of the blood-washed band. Well, praise God, I'm a member of the blood-washed band. I've been washed in the soul-cleansing blood of the Lamb. I was bound by chains of sin till one day the Master came and made me a member of the blood-washed band.
Forget the fact that he's the same all the time.
He doesn't have bad days. All his days are good. And he's always there. He's always there every day. And all I need to do is remember that and just say to myself and to say to him, look, I'm having a bad day, but I know you're there to help me. Remember this thing, and these are kind of the words of this song. The God that's up on the mountain, he's the same God that's down in the valley. Remember that.
Life is easy when you're up on the mountain and you got peace of mind like you've never known. But then things change and you're down in the valley. Don't lose. Sometimes my load gets heavy with the things I carry. This world puts upon my back, but all I have to do is think where I'm headed to, and I find no reason to turn back. When you look for me, look around the throne. I'll be singing with the angels. Glory to his name, that forever I've been changed. So look for me around the throne.
The half has not been told of the sights I shall behold when I get to my new home. But the one I long to see is the one who set me free. So look for me around God's throne. On the road to glory, telling my new story.
Here among the shadows, living in a lonely land, strangers, we're a band of pilgrims on the move. Dangers burdened down with sorrows, and we're shunned on every hand.
But we are
looking for a city built above.
Yes, we're looking
here and there, for a city.
Looking for a city underwhere.
Going here and there, we're simply trusting in the blessed Savior's love and mercy. Though we may be strangers, living in a world of care, we're always looking for a city built above.
Yes, we're
looking here and there, looking for a city underwear. Thank you.
Christ, oh, rest on your face.
That's the long one. The second half is a little easier, not quite as many songs.